Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Last Tuesday was the Chinese New Year, the year of the tiger. I hope the tiger symbol and the spirit will bring good fortune for all of us. Back when I was a child, China was economically a very poor country. However, even in that social and economic condition, children normally enjoyed New Year's a lot. I still have vivid memories of the excitement and happiness I used to feel every New Year season. Compared to other children, I especially enjoyed this period since many martial art practitioners would visit my grandfather to pay their respects since my grandfather was a senior member in the community. I had a lot of great opportunities to meet some great martial art teachers and listen to their stories during their conversations. Their stories amazed me as a kid and continue to amaze me even today. I have to say that a considerable portion of my martial art knowledge was gained as the direct result of listening to their conversations. But at the same time, the New Year did not in the least mean I would get a break from practice. As I have mentioned before, I had to practice every day and New Year's Eve and New Year's Day were no exceptions. And this approach lasted until my early 20s. I did not complain about daily practice at all since practice was just another part of my daily routine, like eating and sleeping. And I still appreciate all my time invested in practice, even today. Today, I'd like to introduce a popular term, 形意24法, or 形意24 method. I have introduced some basic practice of Santi posture in some of my prior videos without a detailed explanation. Some community members also asked me about the 24 methods, and I told them I would make a video to introduce Santi's stance and the 24 method in the future. So, today's the day. Of course, Santi posture is the first stance to perhaps everyone when they start practicing Xing Yi. And there's no shortage of materials introducing Santi. However, the same isn't true for the 24 method used in Hebei Xing Yi. The 24 method have existed in Hebei style Xing Yi since the third generation, but have largely been neglected by the community. I would like to introduce the 24 method today to systematically elaborate different critical practice requirements about the Santi posture. Topics covered in today's video include: first, introduction to the 24 method. Second, different versions of 24 method. Third, content of the 24 method. Fourth, application principles of the 24 method. Fifth, misperceptions of the Santi posture. Sixth, demonstration. And seventh, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Topic 1. Introduction to the 24 methods. Throughout Xing Yi history, practitioners of different generations have emphasized the importance of Santi Shi or Santi posture. Briefly speaking, Santi posture is the basic practice that reflects the fundamental concept of a posture or stance. In other words, Santi posture provides a basic idea of how the body should maintain a correct posture in a static state. Like I mentioned before, one important difference between the Chinese styles and many other styles is the stance practice. Chinese styles, both internal and external, practice certain type of stances for specific purposes. In the case of 形意, practicing stance is to help a practitioner understand basic practice principles and body structure, among other benefits. I have a prior video about Santi practice. In that video, I corrected my student's Pi Quan. However, in the beginning of that video, I corrected his Santi posture. Let me replay that part and you will have a better idea about it. Unfortunately, that video was short for China and the language used in that video is Chinese. But still, it is a good idea to have a look.
首先要注意这个问题，前手不要太高，因为这个身子要一个角度，什么角度？一般来说是要有30度到15度的这个角度，不要特别直。第一个，第二个呢，这个手的角度不要太靠肩前，略往中线，略往中线走。第三个，这个指尖一定要用力 ，finger deep flex， 虎口一定要圆撑。掌心内涵，坐腕不闪裂。它什么高度？一般来说，胸的高度。后手护脐，或者是略地于脐，指尖朝前。
So turn finger point forward。
后手只要弯。
弯的这个后，也是 push and heel。
所以后掌掌根踏地，指尖弯。然后呢，在这个动作基础上，头上也开始上。下颌回收，然后要颈背松胸，背要圆起来，弯的背，来弯的拆死，垂肩坠肘，前脚的脚趾尖脚尖冲前就可以，就膝盖别往前顶，但是腿还要保持这个弯度，重心靠后，一般3-7、4-6都可以，或者4-5-步都可以。那说呢，关键是后腿的膝盖要冲着脚的方向。这就基本的架就可以了，就在这个基础之上再动作。
After years of practice and teaching, I realized that teaching stance practice to children is an effective way to build their body strength as well as mental focus. However, as for adults, unless you want to practice Santi for health benefits,you do not have to hold this posture for a very long time. In my opinion, a few minutes of correct practice is sufficient as part of a daily routine. In other words, quality over quantity, even though the accumulation of quantity will make the quality change. Also, it is worth noting that to achieve the ideal result of a Santi practice, you absolutely need to practice it correctly. Now, what does the word correctly imply here? Well, you have to follow the 24 method. In other words, understanding and applying these 24 details in your Santi practice will provide you with maximum benefits.I will explain the 24 method in today's video to clarify important but easily misunderstood and misrepresented concepts so that you will have a better idea of it. So, is there only one set of 24 method in the 形意 community? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 2. Different versions of 24 method.The 24 method are a set of guiding principles for Santi practice. It consists of 8 words, and each word has 3 practical aspects. So, in total, there are 24 aspects about Santi practice. Different names, including 八字、八要、 or 酒药 have been used to describe it, but they all talk about the same concept in the end. By the way, there is a practice in Hebei-style 形意 called 八字功 or 8-word practice, which consists of 8 sets of techniques that focus on martial application. 八字功 was also created by Li Cunyi in Tianjin. Please do not confuse the 八字 or 8 words used in the 24 method with the 八字 as 8 sets of 形意 martial techniques.There are different versions of the 24 method. The earliest version was taught by Li Cunyi. I still have a hand-copied version of his document. You can also find it in Dong Xiusheng's book titled 月氏一拳五行经义. In this book, Dong Xiusheng has clearly stated that he received the document outlining the 24 method from Li Cunyi in Tianjin. While I compare my copy and the version in Dong Xiusheng's book, I noticed only a single word differences, which was effectively the same word with the same meaning but written in different formats. The second version of the 24 method is found in the book titled 形意母拳, written by Jiang Rongqiao, who was a disciple of Zhang Zhaodong and thus a Kung Fu brother of my grandfather, Liang Qinglin. There are some differences between Li Cunyi and Jiang Rongqiao's version. I asked many people, including my grandfather, about these differences, to which I received a constant response.Both Li Cunyi and Jiang Rongqiao's versions talk about the same idea but are worded differently. Li Cunyi is the Kung Fu uncle of Jiang Rongqiao, as both Li Cunyi and Zhang Zhaodong learned from the same teacher, Liu Qilan. Li Cunyi was the first to develop the 24 method, which were later borrowed by Zhang Zhaodong, his Kung Fu brother and very close friend. Later,When Jiang Rongqiao wrote his own 形意 book, he made some modifications to the 24 method based on Zhang Zhaodong's teachings and his own understanding. But the core concept was left intact. Later on, I reached the same conclusion. The third version of the 24 method was written by Xue Dian.Xue Dian's version is very close to Li Cunyi's, since Xue practiced for a short time with Li Cunyi, and Li Cunyi's concept was the predominant one in the Tianjin 形意 community. That's why Xue Dian's writing is very close to Li Cunyi's. In this video, I'm going to use Li Cunyi's version as a reference to explain the 24 method in Santi practice.The reason is very simple. First, Li Cunyi's version is the oldest document on the 24 method. Also, Li Cunyi's version is very straightforward and much easier to follow. I have studied all three 形意 branches of Li Cunyi, Zhang Zhaodong, and Xue Dian, and I fully understand their similarities and differences. But for the purpose of introducing a concept,It's much easier to focus on the commonalities than the differences between the different branches. Again, all three branches are correct in terms of a practical aspect, but they emphasize different details. So, focusing on differences can divert the audience's attention toward the differences and away from the commonalities, which is bothunnecessary and more importantly, counterproductive. Of course, differences are important too, which I will introduce in the future. Topic 3. Contents of the 24 method. These 8 words are 顶 or pushing, 扣 or inward bending, 圆 or rounding, 毒 or being fierce, bow or embarrassing, 垂 or dropping, 曲 or curving, and 停 or extending. Since each word emphasizes three aspects in Sandi practice, in all of the classical documents, the word san or three has been added in front of each of the aforementioned eight words. Let me explain them one by one. The first side is sanding, three pushes. First, 头上顶有冲天之雄。The head pushes upward as if extending toward the sky. Second, 手外推有推山之功。The hand pushes outward as if pushing a mountain. And three, 舌上顶有吼舌吞象之容。The tongue pushes to the palate like a snake swallowing an elephant. Very strange imagery, I know. All of the three pushes are important in strengthening the Santi posture, especially the tip of the tongue pushing on the palate, which according to Taoism will help energy circulation in the body. Also, the top of the head extending upward will extend the spine, strengthening the turning force generated by the lower dantian area. The second side is san kou, or three inward bending. First, 肩扣则气力倒轴, bend shoulders inward so that the power will arrive to the hands. Second, 掌扣则气力倒手, bend palms inward so that the power will strengthen the hands. And third, 手足指扣则周身力后, bend fingers and toes inward so thatThe power will strengthen the whole body. Kou indicates that the inward bending motion will strengthen the power. However, it should be done naturally without being stiff. Any overbending motion will violate the Xingyi principle, which is that all the movements and the motions should be executed naturally, especially in a stance practice.The third side is the san yuan, three roundings. In Chinese, round here does not mean a circle. It means a circular motion or a sphere-like shape. First, 脊背圆则力催身前, or round the back so that the power will push the body forward. Second, 胸圆则两功力全,round the chest so that the power will strengthen the arms. And three, 虎口圆则勇猛外宣, or round the tiger mouth area to be able to send out the power. This word emphasizes the importance of a sphere-like shape in stance practice, which is the basic requirement of any internal martial art practice. Maintaining a sphere-like shapeIn these three areas will make the upper body strong and solid, enabling power transfer to the hands. The fourth side is san du, three fears. Du can also mean sharp or vicious, but I prefer to use the word fears here. First, 心毒如怒里扑鼠, the mind is fierce.Like that of an angry cat catching a mouse. Second, 眼毒如视兔之鸡鹰。Vision is fierce, like that of a hungry eagle looking at a rabbit. And three, 手毒如浦阳之恶虎。Hand is fierce, and just like that of a hungry tiger catching a sheep. The word 毒talks about the mind in stand practice. I have to remind you that in practice, you should not have this kind of facial expression. You should maintain an outwardly neutral facial expression. 三毒 simply implies maintaining an alert mental state in practice without any emotional disruptions. The fifth set is 三抱 or three embracing or holding or containing. 抱 or holding or embracing is the word used in Chinese martial art which describes a containing motion or intention. Here, you have to understand the term hold, which is a term used to express the feeling of containing a structure, not physically holding an object. First, 丹田抱气，气不外散。丹田 holds the energy without dissipation. Second, 胆量抱身，临敌不变。Martial spirit holds the body without being intimidated when confronting your opponent. And three, 两肘抱肋，出入不乱。Two elbows hold the ribcage area so that moving inward and outward is not messy. Be careful here. The word hold here does not mean physically push inward into the ribcage area. Well, think about this. Can you really use two elbows to hold your ribcage in standing stance, since one arm is extended and its elbow is in the extended position as well? In this case, the word hold means to contain, embrace, which is both a motion as well as an intention. The word embracing or holding is a very subtle detail. You cannot physically hold and embrace anything at this point. It is an intention more than a physical movement. It is a key practice of internal style martial art. The sixth side is 三锤 or three dropping. The word dropping does not mean that you have physically dropped something downward. Instead, and again, it is an intention and a structural motion. First, 气锤则气降丹田 or energy drops so that 气 will move to 丹田. Second, 肩锤则力摧肘前 or shoulders drops so that power will push elbow forward and 肘锤则两腕撑圆 elbows dropped so that wrist will be extended with strength. The motion and intention of the sinking or dropping downward in the stance is the key elements to relax the body or the structure is floppy. The seventh set is 三曲 or three curving or bending. First, 两弓一曲则力复。Both arms curve to strengthen power. Second, 两股一曲曲则力凑。Legs are curved at the knees so that the power is intensified. And third, 两腕一曲曲则力后 and wrist remain a curved shape so that the power will be stronger. Maintaining an extended motion by emphasizing these three types of curves will make your posture more solid and stable, which is the primary objective of stance training. And the eighth and the final set is 三停 or three extending. Again, in a stance practice, that is more of an intention and not a forced motion. First, 挺头则精气灌顶 extend the head upward so that the spirit will extend to the top of the head. Second, 挺腰则力达全身 extend the lower back so that the power will reach the whole body. And third, 挺膝则腿肩麻纹 extend the knees forward so that legs will create a solid stance. This word emphasizes the importance of outwardly extending motion. which is the foundation of 支撑力 or supporting power in different directions, an ideal result of stance practice. So, those were the 24 methods of Xing Yi Stan Ti practice, stemming from the 8 words. Now, what are some common principles of the 24 method? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 4, application principles of the 24 method. These 24 methods are very important to practice Stan Ti stance correctly. There are many small details within this 24 method. Actually, they are not hard to master if you pay attention to each aspect. Also, you do not have to focus on all of them at once. You can begin by focusing on one of them, then move on to another one, and then another, and so on. Eventually, you will be able to work on all of them simultaneously. In order to help you master this practice better, I'd like to talk about two principles of it. First, Stan Ti stance is the static practice, but you should add small dynamic movement into it, especially when you are working on adjusting your structure according to this 24 method. Adding subtle movements to improve your stance training is a key aspect in making progress in practice. Remember, a stance is not a purely static practice. In reality, it is a subtle dynamic practice which involves continuously adjusting the posture. So, my approach is that you should look for a dynamic approach in a static stance. Of course, there are some specific practices involved to get to this level, which will be introduced in the future. By the way, I will introduce an exercise in the demonstration section. It can be used to practice this. Second, do not try to mechanically apply any of the 24 methods in your form or routine practice. You have to know that each of the 24 methods were designed for a specific reason. There's no such universal law in martial practice. It is a very important principle since it is related to methodology. Speaking from a personal experience, I have been able to continuously improve my own martial practice over the last 4 decades because I have regularly analyzed classical documents in terms of both theory and practice. You may have heard of Wang Yangming, one of the 4 most important scholars in the history of Confucianism. Wang Yangming created the famous term 知行合一, unity of understanding and action, meaning that understanding of real knowledge and action should unify together. Knowledge will not be the real one without action. Wrong action implies wrong knowledge. I have a video on bone force, muscle force, and tendon force. Link is in the description. In that video, I have introduced Wang Yangming and his thoughts. So, in martial art practice, practical application of a concept is necessary in order to fully understand the concept. Therefore, it's important to consciously apply the 24 method with focus on their meanings instead of mechanically applying them, or else you will not make progress in your practice. Before concluding this section, I would like to point out that this 24 method approach can also be applied to Bagua practice. Since the Stan Ti posture is the focus of today's video, I will talk about 24 method and Bagua practice in the future. So, those were 2 important principles for working on the 24 method. Of course, there are many more which I will save for the future. Topic 5, misperceptions of the 3T posture. Since the 24 method focused on 3T practice, I'd like to use today's video as an opportunity to clarify a common misconception about 3T and the 24 method. Many people think that 3T is the combat or fighting posture. Actually, it's not. 3T is practiced for understanding body structure and not meant to be used in combat situation. Theoretically, any martial art posture or movements could be used as a guarding posture in a combat situation. However, if you want to improve the effectiveness of a posture that can be used as a guarding posture, 3T is not an optimal solution. Throughout my Xingyi education, all my teachers taught me that the typical guarding posture was to just hold your hands in either closed fist or in open palms in front of the chest, and to never use the 3T posture in combat situations. So, 3T should not be used as a guarding posture in combat situations. Furthermore, the 24 method were created to strengthen the body by working on subtle movements. So you should internalize these details and make them a part of your subconscious martial mind, which will help to improve substantial practices later on. Topic 6, demonstration. Today, I'd like to demonstrate a Xingyi exercise which will show you how to add small dynamic movements into a static stance. Many movements are very subtle, so I will exaggerate them a bit to make them obvious. But in your actual practice, you have to make the movements smaller. So this is the practice. You can just keep this kind of stance, just like you practice 3T stance. Then you extend with strength, then relax, then strength, then relax, extend with strength, then relax, then relax, then tense again. Then you can repeat this many times with different speed. Okay, then even body can extend more. Then you can repeat this many times. Topic 7, takeaways. First, the 24 method are a set of principles to guide 3T posture practice, and it was created by Li Cunyi. Second, different versions of 24 method exist, but as the original version of created by Li Cunyi, followed by modification from Jiang Rongqiao and Xue Dian. Third, there are 8 words, including Ding or pushing, Kou or inward bending, Yuan or rounding, Du or being fierce, Bao or embracing, Chui or dropping, Qu or curving, and Ting or extending. Also, each word has 3 specific methods, so in total, there are 24 methods. Fourth, application principles of the 24 method. First, 3T stance is a static practice, but you should add small dynamic movement into it. Second, do not try to mechanically apply any of the 24 method in your form or routine practice. Fifth, 3T posture is meant to strengthen and improve body structure, not as a combat posture. Remember to check out the demonstration section to get a better idea on how to follow the 24 method in your 3T practice. That brings us to the end of today's video. Thanks for watching. See you next time and enjoy your practice.